Hi, it's Leo from Made by Marley. Welcome back to our channel. Today I am going to be showing you the new decoupage paper release. Say hello, Martin.
Hello.
So we're both here. I'm both quite excited to show you. So this isn't quite a summer release. It was just a release. We will have an autumn winter coming up soon. So I'm not going to do too much talking about it. I'm going to just start showing you. So if you have a look here, Martin's also going to put the things on the wall. So this is called Enchantment Under the Sea. Now you might remember this paper. I used it a long time ago, but this is one of the papers that I most asked for to print it. So I thought, I'm just going to bring it out as a paper. It was part, I thought it was an afterthought, but I thought, no, nah, I'm going to do that. So it comes with one gorgeous mermaid going this way, one gorgeous mermaid going that way, and a complimentary sheet, which you can cut up and use for drawers, or you can cut up and use sides, or you can fussy cut some of it, or you can just put it on the sides. You name it, you can do it. I will show, I'll get Martin to put a photograph of the piece of furniture that I did with Enchantment Under the Sea, just so you can have a wee look at it. Okay, next. You've seen this one as well. This one here is called Good Boy Polly, and it's the one with the parrots, the one that was Bridgerton inspired. It comes with parrots going this way, parrots going that way. And new for this release is I've done a lot of papers that go for drawers, and this one. All you need to do is find the paper that's in the pack. They don't all have drawer papers, but this one does. And find the natural cut area. So that way you're also getting a cut. And you can see it there on the big screen. I mean, that's your natural cut line there. Okay, so this is Good Boy Polly. Next up, we have this beauty here, which is called Kansas. Okay, it's called Kansas. It has a lovely, gorgeous lion on the front. I always kind of stepped away from things like this, but if I'm honest, it was kind of Wizard of Oz was running through my mind at the time. I really like it. I like the blues in it as well. It gives you a lot of scope. If you're an Annie Sloan painter, Givenchy will work really well with this. And you can also use Emperor Silk. So it comes with this one. And it comes with this one, which I thought would just give you different elements you could rip up and add to the main focal part. So you've already kind of got a design going. And this sheet here, which is the drawers. And with this, you just need to cut across there and you've got your drawers as well. So this one here with the lion on it is called Kansas. Okay, next up, it wouldn't be me without a little bit of this kind of zhuzh. This is called Namaste. Okay, it's got two large form elephants, because I was thinking cupboard doors at this stage. So it's got two elephants like this, and it's also got two elephants in smaller. Now, it's up to you. I'm not trying to tell you what to do with them, but if it was me, what I'd probably do is cut it across there, and the excess on your drawers are cut again and do two pieces on either side, and that way you're getting this detail around your edges. So this is Namaste. Next up we have this one here. It's called Still Life. It's been really popular. Some of these are opened and some aren't, but it doesn't matter. Wait till I get it out.
The anticipation.
So I was thinking of a kind of like an old-fashioned still life. So all my elements were different and I put them on the same sort of layering that I like to do. So I decided that I thought that one of the vases should have sunflowers and maybe a little bit of kind of things round about it. I have one of these just with the vase, and it's pretty centered as well, because I thought this would be quite nice for smaller crafts as well, or small bedside cabinets or smaller furniture or inside of a drawer. You know, when you want to do some wall art and you could get, you know, some stamps and things and decorate around about it. And the last one, it's off to the side, and it's actually got an old boot because I was thinking it was sitting on the floor in an old vintage home in a hallway. So something like that for that one. So this one is called Still Life, and you can see it all. Martin's showing you on the big screen. Still Life. Okay, next we have, here we are. It's called Purple Rains. And in this one, I've kind of done something a wee bit different. I've thought that they could go together with your midline on drawers to make it look kind of almost symmetrical. I thought that was quite a nice idea, a little bit unusual placement, but it doesn't have to go like that. You can put it this way, you can put it any way you want. And there's the drawer sheet, and I've made it quite plain and clear where you cut it on this one. Just go down this line. A lot of this one here could be worked with a lot of stamps, because they're, although it's not predominantly very Indian inspired, most of my paper I'll have some sort of mandala or a sort of lattice, an Indian sort of kind of vibe to it. So that's what to do. And with this one here, if you're an Annie Sloan painter, you could use a little bit of Antibes green with a little bit of old ochre in it to make your light green. Or you could use Rodmel for your purples, and Emperor Silk and a little bit of Tilton for your apples. So that's just giving you a little bit of clues of the page. Next one's a little bit different. Mark's smiling.
More and more like Bob Ross every day. Here we are, Mr. Paints.
Burnt ochre. I wanted to create something that was quite William Morris inspired. So I looked a lot at William Morris's patterns, and I have subtly done two sets of paper that I kind of took my inspiration from William Morris. So this one here is called Cloudy Day. It's called Cloudy Day because it's got quite a lot of blues in it. There's a lot of detail underneath here. And if you were mixing and applying this onto furniture, I would start with Annie Sloan's arles and maybe some hornflower for some stamping. And then I would rip this one and put it into different positions to give you your flowers and your drama. But of course, feel free to just paint your furniture a really nice light blue and put this in the apertures. That works as well. So it comes to this one and this one and this one. There isn't a draw sheet with this one. I wanted to keep it quite uncomplicated and just, you know, you could do what you wanted with this one. So this one here is called Cloudy Day. Right, next up, I'm going to have to do a whole load of opening again. This one here is fun. I'll tell you why. Think of all of the Made by Marley decoupage papers that's in our collection, all of them. They don't have borders. La la la. These border sheets, there's three of exactly the same. They're all the same because I wanted you to have enough border to go around things. But if you think of even things like going back to our very first lease and look at my darling Clementine paper, borders, it goes with this. It will go with fireworks. It will go with Namaste that I've just showed you. In fact, there's a little table down here with Namaste and the borders on it as well. So all you need to do with this is just cut them out, and you can cut them thinner. You don't have to have one big wide border. You can have this thin border here. You can have this little blue border. There's potentially 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, maybe 7 borders that you can get out of this sheet. And just do your normal, apply it with Mod Podge, do your decoupage first or your paint, and then just pop it onto the furniture. Or you can keep it big form, or you can try and work with the borders paper just on its own. But I just thought, this is what we need. We need some borders, and I will bring out more borders in the next set of papers. Okay, that's that one. Okay, next up we have, this one here is another one of the William Morris ones that I tried really hard to kind of, I didn't want to copy it. I just wanted a nod. Martin's probably saying, why did she not open all these before we began? Forward thinking. Oh,
why didn't I do that for you?
doesn't matter, Martin. So this one here is called Timeless. Why is it called that? Because I just thought the greens and the sort of bougie reds, it's quite timeless with the cream added to it. And I think for me, it's actually quite classy. But there's whole loads of different things happening underneath the paper, because you know how I build it all up in layers. So it wasn't just my designs on top of it. It makes it up in layers. And this one here, I thought, there's this one. And I'll just flip it round. This one does the same as the other one. No, it doesn't do the same as the other one. Why did I think it did?
The mirror image of each other.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you, Martin. I was like, why did I think that? Yeah, so these two go together, and there's one that I thought just has a lot more branches on it, which I thought would be really nice coming down for drawers, whether you cut it this way or not. I mean, that's up to you. But this one here is called Timeless. It's quite classy. Quite classy for me. Okay. I'm going to put my glasses on, because then that way I've got maybe more hope of opening up the plastic. This one here doesn't have a funky name. It's just called Art Deco. Why? Because I think we ran out of names. What is Art Deco all about? I've kind of got into Art Deco recently. It was never really my jam, but I think that I've kind of got into the shapes, the colours, how it's all. And so what I did was I took Art Deco and I kind of ran with it, and I layered it all up on top of everything else, because that's my sort of favourite thing to do. So on this one, it's all a little bit different. So I've got this design, but I also have it in white. Okay. So these two can be used in conjunction with each other. Maybe focal, and you could cut this round here for your borders. And then what I did was I thought, I'm kind of getting into recently applying my decoupage paper as solid, as ripped for transitions, and lastly, as fussy cutting it to add something a little bit more bougie to the whole thing. So I've done this sheet as well, because I thought that way you can add to it. And just think, if you can paint a simple green leaf and add it beside this, suddenly you've got like a kind of almost a kit to put something together with. So this one here is called Art Deco. Okay, we're getting through them now. This one here is called Cool Beans. Have you ever seen like sacks that have coffee in them, and you can only see some of the writing and it looks a little bit distressed, but it's sometimes got really pretty pictures on it? This is what I tried to do here. I have the hummingbird going this way on it, and I'm going to do something quite big with this one. And this one here could be a drawer sheet, because there's the natural cut line here. So because I've got a hummingbird here and I've got one up here, so you would have your natural cut line. And I've got this one here. Now these don't go together, the writing doesn't go together. What I suggest, I wanted something that you could put in two separate drawers, but then what you could on doors, and what you could do is just get a big bulky stencil and try and put the words on. You don't have to, that's just my thoughts on that. There's an awful lot of layers on this. It's got a sort of script font underneath it. It's got a lot of distressing, kind of blocky, but then it kind of pulls it all together with the kind of the feminineness of the flowers and the birds. So this one here is called Cool Beans. And last but not least, because everybody keeps, I showed a sneak peek of this and everybody keeps asking about it. This one here is called Moonstruck. It has... And again, this was pretty Art Deco inspired for me. I was looking for symmetry as well as a moody sort of background. It's quite dark for me. But, you know, I think the marketing for Made by Marley paper this year was a little bit like, you know, break up with sad beige and have a new relationship with pattern and colour. So not everything has to be colourful to embrace the pattern element. And I thought it would be moody with the moons to go a little bit darker on this one. You can add lots of cream. You can add, if you've got Annie Sloan paint, Coolabar Green. You can add Oxford Navy, gold stamping and stenciling in the background. Cut it up. Don't cut it up. Apply it as it is. So this one here comes with two of the large form dragonflies, because I thought cupboard doors or tops of furniture, anything like that, this will work really nicely. And a nice cream like stamp, stencil, anything. This is the sort of Art Deco parts that I was trying to add to it. And this one here with all the little dragonflies going across it is for drawers. so that you've got that there's your natural cut line there and there for your drawers. So I think I've tried to kind of look at my paper now as a whole, as a furniture artist. It's not just a picture of this. It's these all work with all of my other papers. Not all of them, but most of them do, because I try and tend to kind of look at it as a whole. So you can mix and match papers as well. And there's some fabulous examples in our decoupage group, which Martin will put a link below to. We have a decoupage group and it's currently running a competition. If you want to enter, I think it's the beginning of September sometime, so you've not got long to do it. All you need to do is create a piece of furniture with made by Marley paper on it. You can use stamps, you can use stencils, you can use any paint, you can use transfers, you can do whatever you want. There's no barriers to creativity.
And there's some great prizes.
And there's some really good prizes. So the decoupage group has fabulous inspiration, and you can mix and match them. And I've seen people do it. Even I'm like, wow, oh, I wouldn't have thought of putting that with that. So that's it. What other benefits has Made by Marley paper got? You don't need to paint the furniture white because it's a little bit more robust. When I designed Made by Marley decoupage paper, I decided that I wanted people to use it and have a really positive experience. I didn't want them to have a bad experience. And sometimes the thin tissue and the thinner papers are hard to work with if you're starting out. That gave me the sort of other thing of, but can you blend them? You can blend this as well. It's just an easier way to apply. There's nothing difficult to Made by Marley decoupage paper. You simply just apply some Mod Podge, put your paper on top of it, wipe it with a soft cloth until you get rid of the wrinkles, and then leave it alone. And when it dries, it will dry wrinkle free. That's all you need to do. It's very easy and to work with. So you don't need white furniture. There isn't a whole load of tools you need to apply it with. It goes with all our other collections. We now have drawers we have catered for. We have borders for some of our other papers and some of the current collection. And really, to be honest with you, it's not about the sales. It's about embracing colour and embracing pattern and finding your happy place in colour and embracing colour. It's not always easy to do, especially if you've always been kind of playing it safe and you think, okay, I just want a tiny pop. But from that tiny pop, you can suddenly go, well, I'm going to try this now, and I'm going to try this now. And Made by Marley paper, you can use it as a novice who's never used paper before, or you can take it to a whole different level. And there are people out there who really do take it to a whole different level. And you can blend transitions, and you can add this, and you can fussy cut, and you can do. So it's a very versatile paper. So I think that's really all I have to say. And this is what I did with Moonstruck. I put the drawer paper with the lots of dragonflies around the top. I sanded it, and then I painted under this edge. I painted it with a blue and white and dark sort of base coat. I raised stenciled to kind of give it the nod to the Art Deco, the sage green leaves. I ripped it up and put it on the corners. I fussy cut this pattern out of the design. I cut out my moths, my dragonflies, and I popped them on the back. And then I finished up the stars, because there are stars in the design. Did the same pretty much here. Added a lot of gold, and down below, this whole band here is the fussy cut pattern as well. I just cut the shape in half so that I could manage to get it all the way across the furniture. Down here, pretty much the same deal. I've done that triangle. I've raised stencil this design. I've put stars and the moon and added more gold elements. It was a blend, and the video's out tomorrow, so you'll be able to, on Sunday. You'll be able to see it on Sunday what I did with this. And it's got an Art Deco stencil down the side. And the sides have been done in the paper and all the way down. So this one is called Moonstruck. So how did I put this chair together? I put the smaller elephant at the top. sanded round it, I distressed it back because I had paint underneath. I then did a really distressed stencil look. I stenciled in here. I put the two elephants in the middle here and I blended the transitions up and I cut the corners out and stuck them there and I did the same down the bottom. On the main, I put the big elephant and I stenciled and distressed up and around it. And if you look down the bottom, I cut parts out the stencil and I put them on the front as well so that it makes a whole design. So that was the little chair. And the little table, I used the borders around the front. So I just put two elephants in it, cut them in a square. There's a little reel on this, and I did each side different because I thought that was quite funky. Sorry for the noise. Yeah, there you go. That's how to use the borders. Okay, this is what I did with still life. I just got the two flowers and I put them sort of opposite sides. I did a bit of stenciling. I did a little bit of dry brushing and I added just cut up paper to the apertures all the way around the table. And I made a contrast for the legs with the colours on the paper. This one here is incredibly easy. So if you're a newbie to Made by Marley and you can see it's smooth, then you can see that it's not that difficult to do. So this is just a cute little table using still life. Not everything has to be complicated. Sometimes you just have something that you just want to give it a little bit of a glow up and you want it to be really easy. And this little shelf was so simple. I did it in about 5 minutes. I just applied the paper to the back, painted the shelves, put the paper around the edges, and this paper here is called Timeless. So in this piece, there is a video for, it's a really good way of showing everything. So you can see these are the drawers and they've been made for drawers and they've got an actual cut line. These were longer than my paper, so I just added a section on either side and you can watch the video for that. These are easy because you've got your rim, so you're just cutting and gluing these into here and the same with here. When it comes to the parrots, I ripped out the paper. I blended a shades of blue around it. You don't have to be a hand painter, but I hand painted some of the flowers in and some I just cut off with the spare decoupage paper and I did some white stamping to make it look like one cohesive piece that goes with the drawers. And inside, I just put the parrots by themselves and blended around them. So you can do all these different things. And this is a great one for showing you just how versatile Made by Marley paper is. And this one is called Good Boy Polly. And lastly, I want to talk about something that we're doing, which is a pre-order, whether you want to give it for a Christmas gift or you just want it for yourself. It's basically furniture art in a box, and it comes with a tutorial, two tutorials, that help you do this. So the box looks like this. This is how it'll be delivered. They'll actually probably, when you get it, it'll probably be a Made by Marley card in it, like that. Okay, so let's open it up and I'll show you what's in it. All you need to do for this is add paint. I've thought of everything. So let's look at the decoupage paper first. These are not the normal decoupage paper. These were designed for this box. So obviously, it's Indian inspired. I'll show you the rest of the contents in a minute. So this is the first one. And in the tutorial, it tells you exactly how to put it together as well. So it's a course and a gift all in one. And this isn't available for anybody else to view it, only the people that get the gift box. But as I said, it's good for gifts, good for presents. And I think it kind of gives the gift of furniture art. So in this you get peacocks. These ones going this way. This is a different view again. Look at all the glorious things you can cut up for borders. Oh. And lastly, elements if you want to fussy cut things on your furniture. And I've put the elements that go into the paper onto this sheet. So if you want to add corners or embellish, I mean, some of these you could glue on handles, corners, because I like a bit of corner action, drawer tops. So this is the peacock, and it actually has four sheets, unlike our normal paper, which just has three. So it's got three with plenty of scope, and I'll get Martin to put them up on the wall. So there's this one, this one, and this one, right? That's the first set you get with the furniture in a box. And this one's peacocks as well, funnily enough, but I put stencils in the box. So for those that want to know about Made by Marley stencils, they will be out before Christmas at some point, but we still don't have a definitive date. I'm going to get there at some point. Okay, so this one I thought is quite bougie and dark, and you can got a lot of scope for colours on this one. This one comes like this. It has this, which I thought you could stamp or write something in this as well. It's got all the paisleys, things that you can cut up for borders, drawer fronts. La la. You don't need a huge amount of skill to be able to do this, because I'm going to run through everything that can make potentially and choices of what you could do. And these are borders, drawers, added flowers if you want to put a wee bit of bougie chinoiserie on it as well. So it's all here in the papers. So you get a chance to do two pieces of furniture. That's the paper. But what else is in the box? All my favourite things. There's a pack of Indian stencils.
The ones that you use all the time.
The ones I use all of the time. These ones here, they're like gold dust.
There's so 12 in there.
There's 12 in here. And these can go really nicely with the furniture, and you'll see that in the video. Palette knives. Because who doesn't like a bit of palette knife action on their furniture? A little bit of distressing and a little bit bougieing up at the end. A good set of palette knives. Mini rollers for our distress. Who doesn't love a set of mini rollers? And these will last you for ages. And it comes with these stencil brushes, but the other one just flew out my hand a minute ago. And three stencil brushes. So you have the decoupage paper, the stencils. So let's break it down into layers. So you have the paper. You paint your piece, put your paper on. Then you have your stencils, stencil brushes for the stencils. Then you do your fussy cutting, add that. And then you do a little bit of palette knife distress. And before you know it, you've got two beautiful Indian-inspired pieces of furniture. So if you're interested in this, there's a pre-order available today. And just go to our website, www.madebymarley.co.uk, and the link will be below. Martin's going, why is she saying that? So it'll be down below. And as I said, it's good value. You're getting free tutorial with this. Well, it's not free, you're paying for the box, but you're getting the tutorial as well. And limited edition paper.
If you know somebody who, you know, covets what you do, and you think, well, how can I get them to
go on a colour journey? How can I get them to go wild and be, you know, really immersed in their creativity? This is the way to do it. I was thinking, You know, there's two ways to do this. You think, well, you give the hard sell, or you can just push people to take a little bit of a step into colour and pattern. So, as I said, it'll be on our website from today for pre-order. And Martin has told me to tell you that everything will all be sent out well in time for Christmas. Okay, that's that. So this has been today's release. Martin, have you enjoyed it?
I have.
Yeah, I have.
I'm excited.
So I am excited.
This has been, you know, like it's been a journey, hasn't it? You know,
it has. Yeah. There's been a few releases now. I can't believe it. It just gets bigger and bigger each year. And I still don't want to lose the closeness of the people who buy from us. Our customers are the most important people. They really are. And I always want to have that connection. So it's just really important to me that that you're happy and you feel inspired to use
it. We're working on plans in the background to make sure that we stay connected with you as well. Mm-hmm. It's really, really important to us.
Yeah, it is. I don't think I did this, but I just want to run through quickly again the benefits of Made by Marley paper. You don't have to paint your furniture white, which is great. It was designed for newbies. If you've ever put tissue, thin tissue decoupage paper on it, it's notoriously hard until you get the hang of it. And I wanted somebody to pick up my paper and feel proud of themselves and love the result straight away. So it's for newbies or people who can blend and want to add pattern and play the transitions. So it really works for two different kinds. You know, you could progress from that to that. Is it a little bit more thick? Yeah, it is thicker. It is more robust, but it's thicker to give you that ease of application. Can you blend up on over the edges? Yes, you can. You definitely can. What else is it good about it? It works with all the papers in our collection, or most of they all work together. So, for example, you know, you can mix this one and this one. And if you join our decoupage group, which the link is below, you get to see other people using our paper. And I am often very surprised on the about what papers people will mix with other papers, which I haven't thought about.
It's a really lovely group as well.
And it's a really nice group. It's very inclusive. In fact, today I asked somebody about hair and they were swapping hairdressing tips. I mean, it's not decoupage, it's not just decoupage. They're just genuinely lovely. So we have that group there, which gives you inspiration about mixing and matching our papers. Why am I pushing the colour and pattern agenda? Why do I do it? Because I know that it's good for mental health. I know that we know that use of colour, having colour in your life does make you feel happier. There's so many different benefits to immersing yourself in projects that are happy projects. And Made by Marley is dopamine-filled design. Just try it out. I mean, that's all you need to do. It's just try it. So, Martin, do you have anything to add to this?
Nope, I think you covered everything.
I'm gonna go now. Okay, so it's available now.
Yeah,
from right now. Right this minute. Go click forth on the link below. Take care. Bye.
Bye.